Be the best of whatever you are is an inspirational poem penned by Douglas Mulloch. He was an American poet and short story writer and associate editor of American Lumberman, which is an adventure magazine based in Chicago. His poem, Be the Best of Whatever You Are, shows how keenly he observed Mother Nature. The title of the poem itself reveals the meaning of the poem and its concept. He is trying to tell us that whatever we do, we need to be the best. He has used examples from the nature to convey his message. The poet wants us to know that no job is less important and we need not be ashamed of what we are. We must take pride in our job and accomplish it with our best effort. The theme of this poem is inspirational and instructional. The poem starts by giving examples of nature. The poet says that if you can't be a pine tree standing tall on the top of the hill, then that doesn't mean you are not worthy enough to be a part of the forest. You can always be the best scrub in the valley beside the rill, making the valley beautiful. The tall pine trees may form large forests, but without scrub by the side of the stream, the valley would lose its charm. So, at least be the best scrub, if not a pine tree. He is trying to say that be the best employee if you can't be the boss. He further adds that if we can't be as strong as a tree, then at least be a bush. Here he again says that if we can't be a bush, then be a tuft of grass, because a bit of grass along the highways can also make it prettier and happier. He then moves to another aspect of nature to prove his point. He says that if you can't be a muskie, a relatively uncommon and rare freshwater fish native to North America, be a bass. But the liveliest bass in the lake. The muskie may be precious and hard to catch, but they are in favorites of the locals. But bass is an edible fish. Douglas Mulloch wants us to be happy and optimistic. He says that if we can't be the captain of the ship, we can be the crew. A captain alone can't sail through the seas. He wants us to know that there is always something for us and we should be proud whatever we are. He explains that in this society, every work has its own importance and no work is to be ashamed of. What would happen if everyone wants to be a doctor or a businessman? Who would look after the smaller jobs of the society? There would be no one to keep our roads clean, and there would be no one to mend our shoes. So he explains that we should do the task which is at hand rather than running towards bigger tasks, as every job needs to be completed. In the last answer, he further adds that if we can't be a highway, we can always be a narrow pathway. Some of the most beautiful parts of the nature are led by trails, not by highways. He further adds that if we can't be the gigantic sun, we should just be a twinkling star. He says that size doesn't matter. Your success will depend only on how good you are at it and if you are making noticeable contribution to the society. The poet concludes the poem saying that you should be the best in your field.